Fisheries Research Institute, KEMFRI. This is a center of excellence in aquatic research in East Africa region, and basically we focused on the development of the fisheries and aquaculture sector, both at the national level and also at the global level. And in terms of our four key focus areas of research, we have seed production. That is the development, production of fingerlings, fish fingerlings from two main species. We have the Nile tilapia and we have the African catfish. So we do selective breeding programs to make sure that we get the genetic vigor. And then through that, we are able to get fast growing fish that can reach the market. Secondly, we also do feed production. And we do the high quality floating feeds in our extruder machine. But apart from that, we now have a very, very interesting research that is ongoing. Basically, we are looking at how the role of macrophytes, and we have one major macrophyte, that is the aquatic plant that we use. We have Lemna minor, it's called duckweed, and this Lemna minor is very, very important in terms of fatty acids, which are very, very important to supplement the conventional feed diets that are used. So the Lemna provides us with good nutrition for the fish.
As you all know, it takes a team to achieve something. And in Sangoro Research Center, we I'm privileged to work with a team. On my right side is Elijah Kembenya, who is in charge of fish breeding. We work with three main species, that is the Nile tilapia, we have the African catfish, and also we have the Labeo victorianus, which is still on trial basis. So Elijah is working on that. Robert is in charge of our feed nutrition department, especially the issues of feed formulation. As I had said, Lemna and these other types of feed ingredients. So Robert takes that, is in charge of that department. And also we have a feed extruder. So he's in one that helps us in analyzing some of the ingredients. Do we have the right quality and such kind of things in partnership with the Kenya Bureau of Standards. But we are supported by the technical department. So we can now go and check on what they are doing, especially harvesting of the Lemna. So that we can use for formulation, and also we can see some fish. Let's see some fish. So this is an example of a liner pond, which is now being used for the production of the Lemna species. You can see that it is already populated, the ponds, and after this we harvest it, and after harvesting, now Robert takes it for the formulation. And then from the formulation now, from here we harvest it, we dry it, and then it is now used as part of the formulation. Another example there is the earthen ponds. The reason why you can see is that the grass should not be inside. So, you can see this is has done quite well, so it's very clean. And from here, we now dry it, and then now we use it to formulate our fish feeds. And this is a very rich source of good proteins and also omega-3 fatty acids, which are very, very important for the fish diet. As we say, fish love, we also want our fish to have a balanced diet, to make sure that we produce quality that also helps us in now feeding our population, especially children under 5 years, because fish has been recognized as a source of very, very rich nutrients. So thank you.
Currently, this ingredient has not been commercialized, and it's under trial to see the level of the omega-3 that is in this ingredient, such that when we really understand fully the levels that are there, they can be extracted and used sustainably for fish feed production. And this culture, like this size of a pond, we can harvest so much from it. So we have many of them. This is our bank. Then we are likely to have enough of these omega-3s to incorporate into the fish feeds to have them very nutritious for our fish.
Research findings are used for commercialization purposes to also benefit our primary stakeholders, who are the farmers, to make sure that they increase their productivity, efficiency and profitability. So here we have our team. It's called the Mercantile Department. From my right side, I have Samson Owala, Robert, we have known. Then Sam is head of our technical department. We have Elijah, we have Bob, we have, you call him engineer, Ondenge, and also we have our friend here, Jared.
Yeah.
So this is the team. I want to demonstrate how we harvest the fish. So after feeding the fish with different feed products and also the formulated fish using Lemna, we now, this is where we do our broodstock. And from the broodstock, we normally pick the eggs from the mouth of the females. And then we grow them in that hatchery. Then now we multiply them into thousands, and then we normally distribute to our farmers for grow out in ponds, in cages, and other culture systems. So here now is the team that is ready to demonstrate how we harvest the fish. So welcome. So after the sexing, we normally remove the eggs from the mouth. Yesterday they did the procedure. We take the eggs in incubation jars and also in our hatchery, where now we produce the large volumes. We grow them, we do the process of sex reversal. We normally induce them, we give them a hormone impregnated feed diet. What we use is called 17-alpha-methyltestosterone. After around a period of 1 or 2 months, it normally disappears in the flesh of the fish, so it's healthy and also very, very important. Because why do we choose the males to grow the males? Because from studies, the males normally grow twice the size of females, because normally feeds, they take time to do the breeding. They take the eggs in the mouth, so they normally do not feed during that time. And they also use a lot of energy for somatic, for breeding, instead of investing it for the growth of the flesh. So that is why normally farmers prefer males to females, especially for tilapia.
Yeah, as we explained earlier, is that this now a hatchery under a greenhouse, whereby we are able to regulate temperatures. So when the temperature is higher, the hatching and growth of fish is also higher, because also the rate of metabolism is higher. So these eggs and larvae you are seeing inside these tanks were harvested yesterday from the mouths of the fish, because they are mouth brooders. And then here we are incubating them. Within 3 days, they start hatching, and actually a few have started hatching, but in 3 days, you will have them hard to swim up, fry. So again, here is where we sex reverse them from a mixed sex to all men. So any female that is in this stock is reversed to all males, but if it is not more than 14 days old. So before the 14 day, the larvae have not differentiated to any sex, so you can reverse them to any sex you want. So for this case, we reverse them to all males because there is a sex dimorphism in tilapia, whereby males grow faster than females. So we prefer the all males stock for stocking the ponds.